Ambassador Ghedin Bahar, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs Special Envoy for Climate Change and Sustainability, thank you so much for taking the time to join us. You know, Ambassador, when I was talking to Ambassador Gilad Erdan a few weeks ago during the Abraham Accord celebrations, I asked him, what's the next big thing for regional cooperation in terms of the Middle East to build upon the Abraham Accords? There's been tourism and trade and even medicine. What's next? He looked at me, he said, it's climate change, it's sustainability, which is why I thought it was so important to talk to you with so many important conferences coming up. What can the Middle East do as a cohesive unit to fight what we're seeing right now in terms of the dangers of climate change?
Well, Ambassador Erdan is completely right. I think that climate change is and should be indeed the cornerstone of regional cooperation in the Middle East and the Eastern Mediterranean. You know that that our region is considered to be a climate hotspot. It means that it is warming up 1.5 times quicker than the world average. And in some parts of it, temperatures have risen even higher than higher than in other parts of the world. Like in the Gulf region, it's already 2 degrees more than what was before the Industrial Revolution. So things are taking a turn to the worse in the Middle East in terms of climate change. But climate change can be also an opportunity for regional cooperation, an opportunity for prosperity, an opportunity to create more ties with different neighbors here in the region. So we have to look at climate change in the Middle East in both ways, one as a threat, but also as a source of opportunities.
The Middle East is heavy on technology, especially when it comes to agriculture, when it comes to environment. What type of collaborations are we looking on between Israel and its newfound partners in the region in terms of battling this front?
We are talking about five different areas of cooperation. One is water. Second is agriculture. Third is renewable energies. Fourth is reforestation or nature-based solutions. And the fifth one is food security and alternative proteins. These are the major acute areas where we need cooperation in the Middle East, because the Middle East suffers from water scarcity, which is the highest in the world. The Middle East imports most of its food from outside, and it makes it very vulnerable to supply chains problems and hazards. The Middle East needs more irrigation, for instance, or agricultural-based irrigation. And the Middle East, of course, needs to preserve its nature or its ecosystems, and to move even into a phase of restoration of ecosystems in the region, either if it's wetlands or forests or grasslands. So all of these five areas give us a solid basis for regional cooperation. And we think that for this regional cooperation to succeed, we need also a participation from external partners like the United States or India or Japan or, of course, the European Union and the United Nations. We believe that there is not even one single country in the region that can withstand the effects of climate change alone. That's why it makes it absolutely necessary to cooperate and to collaborate in this field. You know that adaptation and resilience building is done basically today on two levels in the world. You have a national level. Each country, according to the Paris Accord, has to make its own adaptation plan, to devise a resilience plan. And there is the international cooperation on climate change, which is manifested through the Paris Agreement and the UNFCCC. But another level of cooperation and of resilience building should be the regional one. And this is where we are starting. And I want to tell you that I was just recently in Cyprus, so the second regional meeting on climate change in the Middle East. And the aim of the Cypriot initiative is indeed to create a regional climate action for the Eastern Mediterranean and the Middle East. And we in Israel, we think that this is an extremely important initiative. We support it. And we full-heartedly believe that regional cooperation is essential for our well-being and our future.
There are so many competing interests when it comes to this region, but we are seeing countries like the United Arab Emirates, for instance, putting an emphasis on food security, putting an emphasis on renewable energies. Are there other countries specifically that have kind of changed the way they do business over the last, you know, 5 years or so that are really adapting to the model that's going to be needed? Or are you having to kind of pull teeth in this regard?
The emphasis should be also put on a truly regional cooperation, because we cannot afford leaving populations or countries behind. Building resilience in the Middle East should be inclusive. If we leave people behind us, populations behind us, which are not resilient or did not take measures to adapt to climate change, it will affect all of us. It will affect the stability of the region. We have seen, for instance, how the civil war in Syria, already 11 years, started partially, at least, because of climate change and severe drought that hit the country 4 years in the years before the war broke out. So climate change is seen as threats multiplier in our region. And in order to minimize threats and to increase the opportunities, because also climate change is a manifestation of opportunities, and we must seize these opportunities, we have to move with a regional plan that will include everyone in the region, practically.
Gideon Bachar, the Special Envoy for Climate Change and Sustainability from the Israeli Ministry of Foreign Affairs, thank you so much for taking the time and giving us your insight on this critical subject that's really capturing global attention, especially around the time of this climate conference in Scotland. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, and let's hope ourselves a very successful COP26. It's crucial. Sure.